With season 6 of Better Call Saul coming soon, with a whopping 13 episodes, hopefully, we don't have much longer to go before all the questions are answered. So I'm going to do a ranking on every individual season and give my general thoughts and opinions before season 6 either ruins or enhances the whole entire series. I'm your free spender on Superbrito, the third, and this is my unofficial, official ranking on every season of Better Call Saul.
Oh, I guess that I'm doing fine.
Season 2 is probably the least interesting season, but it is cool to see the reason why Chuck thinks the way he does about Jimmy. And yes, I am going to say it. I do like Chuck.
You suck!
Okay, let me rephrase that. I don't hate him, because I've definitely been that kind of guy before. You could definitely tell the creators wanted to go in a slower direction. Vince Gilligan said so himself.
My source of anxiety in season 1 was the damn name of the show is Better Call Saul. And I'm worried people aren't going to think he's badass enough. We got to get to Saul Goodman as quick as we can. That was my fear and my thought all through season 1. And then I started to see the shows edited together, and I started to hear anecdotally how people are reacting to it. And it started to dawn on me, hell, I really like Jimmy McGill. Now in season 2, as we work on it, I'm thinking, how long can we put off Jimmy McGill becoming Saul Goodman?
So I guess that's why season 1 was more well-rounded. And it's the first season where the intro gets distorted into black and white, foreshadowing Saul's fate. Definitely not a bad season, just not that memorable, which I guess is something you're going to want in a ranking. Oh yeah, and Squat Cobbler.
Address unknown, oh how could I be so blind?
There isn't much to say about the first season, other than it's a nice introduction to the show in the prequel universe of Breaking Bad. It gets its general themes and messages across, with a bow on top. Season 3 is the height of the Jimmy vs. Chuck arc, and it does go some pretty interesting places, at least for the first half, which I can't excuse because it does still stay pretty consistent. And also, this is the first appearance of Gus in the season 2. The flash forward at the beginning of the season was pretty lackluster and didn't really introduce any new aspects to Gene's character. Same for season 2, although the ending does build up to the season 4 and 5 flash forward and the rest of the storyline.
My shadow and me.
Season 4 is about the aftermath of Chuck's death, and the effects it has on Jimmy is interesting character development, especially with him trying to get his law degree back and slowly gaining that nihilistic outlook. Especially the ending.
Wait, Jimmy, what?
It's all good, man.
And it's a similar case for Mike. They use the construction of the mess lab from Breaking Bad to treat for the downfall of his character. And side note, I guess it wouldn't really make sense if they did finish the lab, because it got finished by the time Gus met Walter in season 2 of Breaking Bad.
Won't you come on in?
Now, I know this is a pretty popular and generic opinion, but trust me when I say this, the whole entire series wouldn't be as memorable if it wasn't for season 5. I mean, who could forget this scene, and this scene, or this flashback? And the opening for the season was really one of a kind too, and nails that isolated and panicked feeling through the visuals. It really made me anticipate what will happen with this character. Meanwhile, the Jimmy turning into Saul storyline is at its peak too. Had me wondering if Jimmy is hurting Kim, or if Kim was hurting Jimmy. And the last episode was something else. It was so intense while being so down to earth as well. It really makes you feel the buildup of the characters through the last 5 seasons. And just imagining that this is the pot before the bang really made me wonder how all this will wrap up in season 6. Although, it does feel like it still could go on for like 2 or so more seasons. Well, that's it. Here's hoping we can get a release date for a trailer soon. And I hope this dude won't die from a heat stroke filming in Albuquerque. Best wishes. I also plan on reviewing season 6 when that finishes airing. So expect a deeper analysis in that one. So that's it. See you in the next one. And where the hell is Bill Burr's character in this show? Like, really?